More than 40 years ago, Mitsubishi Materials started making gas discharge tube surge absorbers, which are alternatively called GDTs. And these allow circuitry to be designed by engineers to prevent surges from damaging their products. We developed our microgap and other technologies, and they allow our GDTs to have wide sparkover voltages from 140 to 7800 volts. These surge absorbers are like a switch, and they're nominally in an open state. And when there's a large voltage surge, they close. These have a very high insulation resistance exceeding 100 megaohms and have a capacitance of less than 1 picofarad, so it's nearly invisible to the circuit until a surge is introduced. This microgap technology works especially well against fast rising spikes like those of a static shock or the induced voltage online after a lightning strike. There's a slight difference between the two words, surge arrestor and surge absorber, but I'll be using them interchangeably. Typical gas discharge tubes have very poor accuracy, and because of that, their sparkover voltage can exceed the amount of voltage safe for the device. A metal oxide varistor, or MOV, or MOV for short, responds to the surge, but the voltage within the circuitry stays at its rated value for the entire shown, and it ages because of it holding onto this electricity every time it's used. In contrast to this, our surge absorbers immediately absorb the surge, and this adds safety to the downstream circuit and allows the use of a smaller MOV than without it. The way a surge is dissipated can be broken into three stages. The process initiates as the surge starts flowing into the circuit and the voltage exceeds the sparkover rating, and then moves into the glow discharge as the current spreads internally until finally being in the arc discharge as the surge is grounded. For our first test, we apply a surge of several kiloamps to a disc capacitor without any safety countermeasures. Unsurprisingly, it blows up in spectacular fashion. Then we place our surge arrestor in parallel with it and watch what happens. It allows any number of surges to be applied without any damage to the capacitor. Placing our surge absorbers between line and ground protects any device plugged into an electrical outlet and is especially effective protecting telecommunication or signal lines. In a power converter, there's an MOV between lines, and then an MOV and a GDT are used between line and ground. This prevents surges from entering through the power mains and protects the circuit from damage. We use this circuit to show you how our GDT prevents surges from hurting the power converter. For our switching power supply, we apply a surge on the line and earth with the surge waveform shown here. When we measure it, we see the surge voltage is much higher at point B after the common mode coil than at point A. The surge applied to the circuit is shown in black. Without using our gas discharge tube absorbers, point B after the common mode coil in light blue has a much higher voltage than before it at A in dark blue, and this shows the evidence of resonating to increase its voltage. In the next test, we add two more surge absorbers, which operate at 200 to 400 volts to the same circuit before and after the coil, and it equalizes the peak surge voltage at points A and B and prevents resonance. Doing this prevents all the circuitry after it from being damaged from a surge. Using GDTs before and after common mode coils improve their toughness against surges. This mock-up represents a switchboard circuit with power flowing through a residual current circuit breaker, and the light bulbs represent any electrical devices which are on this circuit. If a lightning strike hits between the lines, the light bulbs explode dramatically, And this is what would happen to any other unprotected electrical devices on the same circuit as well. Using our LITOL device prevents this type of damage. Thank you for spending your time looking at this, and I hope this has been of help for you. If you have any questions, please contact us. Thank you.